Hello, it's me again, Mayor Catherine Pugh. What a very busy week we had last week. And it started out at my alma mater. They had what they call a hack, where you have young people coming from all across the country. These are high schoolers, included also our young people from Poly were there. There's a STEAM competition going on. So I welcome them to Baltimore, look forward to whatever they develop. And then I had the great pleasure of going to BCCC, our Mayor Scholars Program, started last week. And someone asked me, they said, you know what, you need to come back in. You can see the parents crying and the children crying because we made Baltimore City Community College free. How exciting. So we've got a summer program for them so that they can be up to speed when they start this fall at BCCC. And then always have these executive team meetings, sort of kind of just hearing from my team what they're working on, making sure they're sticking to my goals and my objectives and our objectives as a city. Had a conversation at the Shakespeare Theater with Aaron Hankin. You probably have heard him on Out of the Blocks, WYPR. Great conversation with him. And then Tuesday, I'm sure you voted, I voted, and they were still counting votes into the following week, I'm sure. But I voted. Not only did I vote, I also attended the various gatherings that took place, including the Democratic nominee for Governor Ben Jealous. Also brought greetings at the Women's Entrepreneur Conference. It was very exciting, encouraging young women and women across the city to get engaged, start their own businesses, and to grow their businesses. Met with the Community Oversight Task Force, heard their recommendations, very interesting. Then, I think I mentioned this to you before, that every day in Baltimore City, Monday through Friday, I meet with my commanders and my staff to collaborate on helping to reduce violence. But once a week, or we go out into the communities, and so last week we were out by in the Northern District at the Family Dollar, walked up and down the York Road corridor, talked with many of the community members. Thank you for greeting me as I walked up and down that particular area, and we're working on it because of a lot of activity going on there and some activity that we need to curb. Went on to announce the African American Heritage Festival. As you well know, is up and coming in August. Ella May is one of the featured guests, so stay tuned for more information on the African American Heritage Festival. We also kicked off our summer food program for our young people to make sure that our young people eat all summer long. So if you have a youth program and you're running a youth program this summer, make sure you get in contact with our office so that we can help you to make sure we're feeding our children. The fire stations have gotten involved, so we're very excited about them working with our food program for our young people. And let me just say, I always get a chance to meet different delegations. The delegation from Crozier was here, and so that was very exciting. And then one of my favorite artists of all times, Poncho Brown, we had a reception for him. He did this exquisite art exhibit. It's still here in City Hall, and featuring music, black music, because this is Black Music Month. So if you get a chance, come down City Hall. Please view those artworks that are in both of the hallways here in City Hall. Very beautiful. And we had a press conference in Park Heights, talking about keeping Park Heights clean, working with LifeBridge Health, who's helping to fund that project. So a cleaner and greener Park Heights, we're looking forward to that as well. A lot of collaboration going on up there, and we're excited about that. I also went and visited the seniors program over in Northeast Baltimore. They were doing trying to keep up with that Billion Step Challenge. I hope you're in the Billion Step Challenge. I was line dancing with them so that we can get those steps in. And I concluded the week with my monthly cabinet meetings and had a great time with one of the great men of our country. Joe Biden was here to help bring Democrats together. So I look forward to having a cup of Joe with Joe Biden. Great week. See you next week.